big act coming on here. Former Congresswoman Susan Molinari, you remember her. She did the keynote address at the last Republican convention, and her baby got more screen time than she did. She hosts a live weekly talk show on America's Voice. I knew they were here. Cable network called The Flip Side with Susan Molinari. Features prominent female journalists, newsmakers, and politicians discussing the issues, and she even let me on it once. That's why I'm nice to her. She's been a guest commentator and analyst on every major broadcast and cable network and most major news programs, and she was formerly co-anchor of CBS News Sunday Morning. She was Glamour Magazine's Woman of the Year in 1996, and she was recognized a few years ago by Time Magazine as one of those 40 most influential people under the age of 40. And I don't think she must still be under 40. And I also have to mention she was elected twice to the New York City Council. Not a bad thing. Here she is, and she's not going to announce for president. I don't think so. Susan Molinari. We're going to do some moving around here a second. Something's happening backstage, obviously.
Something's happening.
And where do you want to work?
I want to just work, stand right here.
Excuse me, guys. I don't know if the union's going to let me do this, but I'm going to try.
Now we got to wait.
I want to get out of your way.
Okay, you get a moment. All right, hit it, guys.
You know, I really shouldn't be here. We don't believe in shrinks. In my world, it's considered a sign of weakness. We don't discuss the private businesses of the family.
Well, I'm a doctor, Mrs. Molinari, and anything you tell me will stay with me.
Well, it better, because if it gets out to my guys or the other families, I'm dead. Where do I begin? Anyway, my father, Guy, brought me into the business years ago.
I'm sorry, did you say a guy brought you in?
Yes.
What was his name?
His name was Guy.
Yes.
What?
The guy?
Right.
What?
What? Damn it, doctor, if you're not gonna listen.
I'm sorry, forget it, go on. This someone brought you into the family business?
Anyway, back in them days, you know, we had a proud, we had a powerful organization. We got respect. Everyone was family. They loved us. They knew we'd protect them. The businessmen, they'd come to our house. And, well, let's call it they donate their money because, you know, they knew we had their best, their, shall we say, special interests at heart. As for the other guys, Doc, we made them an offer they just couldn't refuse. And the press. Well, back then, I gotta tell you, you could buy them a few cocktails, fix them up with a few broads, and they kept quiet. Hell, they just wanted to be a part of the gang. We made the laws, we made the rules, and we enforced them. No one dared challenge us. It was beautiful, just freaking beautiful. All the families across the country got along. We'd divide them up in the districts, and we'd bring home the bacon, you know what I mean? No bickering, no backstabbing, no bosses, no captains got whacked. Hell, we even had a contract with America. Yeah. Them were the days. There were the D'Alessandros from Baltimore, father and son, Tommy and Tommy. And the big guns like the LaGuardias and the D'Amatos in New York. And New York always had the finest families. But today, only the Pataki and the Giuliani still have the power. And even Giuliani's been challenged by a new, more vicious gang from Arkansas, for God's sake. And if that ain't enough, it's abroad to boot. But in our family, things, they just started falling apart.
What happened?
Hey, in 1994, my family came to power after 40 years in exile. But our boss, Don the Newt Gingrich, he couldn't control his people. Like Tom, the exterminator, DeLay. Choir boy Bill Paxson and all the young Turks. And then there was Dick the Salamander Army. Things they really got, I don't know, Doc, they got so ugly. Shakedowns and greedy deals with bookmakers drew too much attention. Then the informants started leaking rumors about us to the press. And that's new, when I knew I had to get out. I finally got out of the racket for an even more dangerous gang. They got no conscience, they got no religion, they got no heart. They'll whack you and you'll never see it coming.
The Russian mob?
Television network executive. Forget about it. They brought me into their circle. They promised me big bucks, fortune, and fame, and then they whacked me with no warning. I'll tell you.
So what happened to your former family in the house?
Hey, if you can believe this, Doc, things even got worse after I left. Our family and the gang from Arkansas, they hated each other. Then our family thought we nailed the Arkansas boss, a bookmaker named Lucianne and her accomplice. Set up a wire on some young chick. The babe was delivering pizza to the Arkansas boss in 30 minutes or less, if you know what I mean. Hey, anyways, the feds, they set up a sting. They caught the Arkansas boss and brought him up on charges of witness tampering and perjury. Our family did everything it could to bring this guy down and take his territory, but that son of a bitch survived. And to top it off, his family, they stayed loyal. I'll tell ya, this guy makes Don Corleone look like a wimp. We really went to the mattresses on this one and we lost a lot of respect from the people in our neighborhoods. And we lost a lot of muscle.
So what happened to your boss, the Newt?
Man, it was ugly. Forget about it. The Arkansas boss wanted to whack him. The rival families on the hill wanted to whack him. But they couldn't get into him in time. The Newt, He lost the confidence of the family and quit his boss. Anyway, now there's these new upstart bosses. They're getting into the act. And they don't understand our traditions, you know what I mean? Donnie Ventura from the north is trying to muscle his way into our territory. Hey, you know what though, Doc? I shouldn't be worried. Because the son of our old boss has come back to reclaim the family business. And believe me, it's gonna be payback time if he wins. But we got this maverick, John the Bird McCain, upsetting the apple cart. They call him the bird because now he's singing like a canary about our racket. Hey, the worst part is, Guy's gone over to the Bird family.
When you say Guy, do you mean...
Doc, don't start with me.
Sorry, go on.
Yeah, my own father went over to keep the Bird family, and now I'm afraid for his safety.
Do you think he's gonna get...
Yeah, bushwhacked.
Why would he help out the Bird family when he knew both you and your husband were still part of the Bush family?
Hey, I don't know. I guess he figured giving a hand to the Bird was worth giving two to the Bush. But, Doc, I don't know. You know, I shouldn't be telling you all this. Because if our enemies ever found out, man, I'd be dead. I mean, I'd get whacked by my own family. If they ever found out I was violating our code of honor by talking to some shrink, I need to know, Doc. Can I really trust you, Doc?
Now, Mrs. Molinari. I'm a professional, and you can trust me with your secrets. Excuse me, I have to take a phone call. Hello? Dr.
Hey, you can't trust nobody in this town, you know what I mean? You can't trust nobody. Thank you.
And the first person we're going to introduce here.